Hello, myself Prasi Vargas. This is a book I have written for General Aptitude, and this is an academy profile of mine where you can get daily live free classes at 11 a.m. and 300 plus free classes you can get if you follow this profile and get to the special classes section. And these are the WhatsApp group and Telegram group details. You can be part of this and get many free resources and daily updates of my free classes. And these are the details of the workshop I conduct for Vedic Maths and Mental Arithmetic. And if you want to be part of more YouTube videos I have launched, General Aptitude with Kristy Vargas keyword, if you search Google or YouTube, you can get all of them. So in this video, this is the concept we are going to learn. Properties of perfect square, or how to identify a perfect square in a competitive exam General Aptitude question. Because in competitive exams, there's a common question that can ask in General Aptitude. Four options will be given. Which of the following is a perfect square? In NET exam, GATE exam, and many competitive exams like that, that is a common question that was asked many times. And there, they will give you options in such a way that you can eliminate three options. And what you should know to eliminate that, that is what I'm briefly explaining using this flashcard. First of all, what is a perfect square? Square of a natural number, and these are the first 60 perfect square listed here. Observing these 60 perfect squares itself, you can get an idea what all can be the unit digit and what all can be the corresponding tens digit. One square up to 60 square, if you analyze, you can understand it. First of all, if you look at the unit digits, you can see that 0 is there in the unit digit, 1 is there, but 2 and 3 are missing. 4 is there, 5 is there, 6 is there, 9 is there, 7 and 8 are also missing. That means among the 10 digits, 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9 only are there. There is no 2 or 3, there is no 7 or 8. Now some of you may be thinking that why I am only looking at the first column and saying that 2, 3, 7, 8 is not possible. Because that same thing is going to repeat in the next column also, right? 11 square and 1 square last digits are same. 21 squares also, 31 squares also, 41 squares also. That is a property of last digit of a power. So definitely these 10 last digits only is going to repeat. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4 and so on. So we learned that unit digit cannot be 2 or 3 or 7 or 8. These 6 possibilities are only there for the unit digit. That means if there is any option with 2 or 3 or 7 or 8 can be eliminated. Now for each of this unit digit, you can predict many things about what can be the tens digit. For example, if unit digit is 0, tens digit should definitely be 0. Look at the 10th row in the second table, you will understand it. 0 ending perfect square can only end in 0, 0. It cannot end in 1, 0 or 2, 0 or 3, 0 or 4, 0 or up to 9, 0. That means any given options which does not have tens digit 0, even if the unit digit is 0, that cannot be a perfect square. And for unit digit being 5, tens digit we can predict correctly, it should be 2 only. In Vedic mathematics, there is a technique also based on this to square numbers ending with 5. Ekadigena Purvena is the sutra we are using there. There also k into k plus 1 comma 25 is the square of any number ending in 5. That means that 25 part will always be same for any number ending with 5 if you square it. That means conversely we can say any perfect square ends in 5 can only end in 25. It cannot end in 15 or 35 or 45 or 55 or 65 or 75 or 85 or 95 or 05 also. 5 means definitely tens digit is 2, just like 0 means tens digit is 0. So that is the second thing you should know. Now thirdly, 1, 4 and 9, we cannot predict exactly what is the tens digit. If unit digit is 1 or 4 or 9, we cannot say what is the tens digit, but we can definitely say tens digit can only be an even number. It cannot be an odd number. It can only be an even number. This yellow highlighted numbers, if you check, you can identify it easily. Again, reminding, I didn't say the square root of the number should end in 1, 4 or 9. I told the perfect squares. Some people misunderstand. They look into this column and misunderstand this theory. I didn't say 4 ending here or 9 ending here. I am telling about for the perfect squares, if the ending or the unit digit is 1 or 4 or 9, then tens digit can only be any of the even numbers. Which even number we cannot predict, but it can only be even. It cannot be odd. That means, simply speaking, 11 ending perfect square does not exist. Not possible perfect square last two digits. Based on this last theory we discussed, 11 ending not possible, 31 ending not possible, 51 not possible, 71 not possible, 91 also not possible, because these all are odd numbers. Similarly, 14 not possible, 34 not possible, 54 not possible, 74 not possible, 94 not possible. Similarly, 19 not possible, 39 not possible, 59 not possible, 79 not possible, 99 also not possible, because of the property that for 1 or 4 or 9, tens digit can only be even. So if you observe what I have told till now, for 0 it is 0, which is also even. If 5 it is 2, which is also even. And for 1, 4, 9, tens digit can only be even. That means all these 5 cases, tens digit will be even. Whether it is 2 or 0 also, still even only. And the only possibility tens digit can be odd is when the last digit is 6. Look at this fourth row and sixth row. 6 ending number or 6 ending perfect square, tens digit will be odd only. It cannot be even. 197531. Similarly, in the sixth column, 6 ending, tens digit can only be 13579, that is odd digit. It cannot be even. That means, what does that mean? 06 ending perfect square does not exist. 26 ending perfect square does not exist. 46 ending does not exist. 66 ending does not exist. 86 also does not exist. So this much property, if you know, you can eliminate options and find the answer. But let me tell you one thing. This is just necessary condition, not sufficient one. That means, it does not mean that if you have 6 in the last digit and tens place is odd, that is confirm a perfect square, we cannot say. But if it is not satisfying this condition, you can confirm say that is not a perfect square. It is just a necessary condition to check. But the good thing is the options will be given such a way that you can apply these conditions. And these conditions you can observe from the perfect squares itself. I just tabulated the observations here. So hope all of you understood this concept and this flashcard. More flashcards like this are available in my Telegram channel media section, Telegram group media section. And you can purchase the book of flashcard if you want, as a printed material if you want. You can get it from Amazon. So thank you all. You can share these videos to your friends if you think that they will like this contents. I will try to post more contents in upcoming days like this on different concepts. Thank you.